Welcome back, everybody, to a snowy Pennsylvania. Today, we're going to show you the all-new Grand Design Imagine AIM 15RB. This is about a 19-foot, 11-inch trailer overall, so it's an under 20-foot unit, and it's a single-axle unit, too, so it's a lot of lightweight for you. It's under 5,000 for gross, so let's check this thing out and see what it has to offer on this little single unit. As you see, this is the front of your Imagine AIM. You do get your 20-pound propane tanks in the front. You do get your electric tongue jack as well, which is still crucial. You're still able to do electric tongue jack on this little unit, which is really nice. And then you still can fit a two battery setup in there if you really want to. So that's crucial too if you're going boondocking or anything like that. You still get two battery systems up there for a little bit more power for going over for a weekend trip or you're doing a week-long trip. It's crucial. They are doing some BAL by the Norco Industries for the frame. It's the NXG frame. So those NXG frames are going to be a little bit lighter, which is able to give this unit the ability to be the gross is going to be $47.95. So your unloaded is about $36.34. So that NXG frame is able to give you that lightness of the trailer and also single axle and a no slide to give you that lightness of weight. But the build inside is still a Grand Design build. It's still a strong structure build, which you guys will see here in a minute. And then on the outside, you still have this little wash bay. So you're still getting able to come run up of your lines, tall plug in, your outside shower, your tank fill, your city fills there, your satellite plug in, cable plug in, and then your solar plug in charger is right there too. Battery disconnect, your 110 outlets, and then your this unit is tire link ready. So that tire link is ready. That means that all you gotta do is purchase the actual tire link system and then it's able to hook up to this unit. And then you see your pass-through storage along here, which obviously when I came in, it noticed me. It is lights that you can keep on that when you do open it up, lights will turn on for you. So they're motion sensored, which are really nice. So they'll turn off when you're not using them. As we take a look going back, you see your vent fan there. You see your black tank flush. You do see this is your single axle unit. So they're putting some Westlakes on there for your single axles. You're gonna get one outlet, one dump tank outlet. So your black and gray tank puller here. And then your one tank is all right there for you. So one system, one outlet makes it very simple to dump your tanks. And then you are getting electric stabilizers. And then both those hot and cold down there, those are just your low point drains. So you can clear everything out before heading out the campground. And then peering back, they still have ladders on these units. So they're still gonna have a walkable roof, so you're able to get up on that unit and walk up there and check those seals every year. It is still backup camera prepped as well. And then this is a 30 amp unit, so your 30 amp plug-in is back here too. Your spray hose, so if you're at a beach or anything to spray off, it is in the back. Just hook up there and you're ready to go. And this is gonna be your Furion tankless water heater. So it's conveniently located in the back unit, which is really nice. And working our way around, you see the whole lights are on the awning, and that awning goes almost the whole length of the unit up until the front pass-through storage. So it's still a pretty long awning for a little 20-foot unit, which is really nice because you still get all this outdoor space. Speaking about the outdoor space, they want a little bit outdoor kitchen. Well, they said, you know what? We're gonna give you a little griddle. So they're giving you a little nice capital griddle that's on the outside here. It does just go in here, and then when you're done, put it up and in here, it's out of the way for you. So it's nicely convenient, you know, tucked away little thing, which is nice. And then your Suburban heaters here. See, this is a Dometic on this they have on here. And obviously your Lippert, it is linked for tire link, and then they still have the Lion's Head 125 lifetime. So the first year is basically your first year, no questions asked, boom, they'll replace your tire if you blow it out. And then you have your fresh water fill, your 110 outlets are here, and then you are getting your step above steps here, which are really nice on a little single axle unit. They're still giving you these heavy duty steps. And then turning around, see, motion activated on the side here, and then here is going to be your other side of your pass-through storage. So that is for the outside of this 15RB. So let's go in and take a look on the inside of this thing. All right, as you guys can tell by now, on this little structure of this 15RB, you're not gonna get a queen bed that's actually out all the time for you. What you're gonna get is this Murphy bed setup. If you've never seen a Murphy bed set up, it's quite cool. You do get a couch. You know, during the day, you're sitting here. You get a little bit extra room on the couch here for the day. At night, then, all you got to do, which I'm going to show you guys right now and demonstrate. So all this is going to do is going to slide forward for you. It's going to sit right here. Come flush right down. Almost to this one, it's going to be right at the edge of these seats here. So getting in at night's pretty going to be hard if this bed's down already. And then over here is just going to be a jack. You just lift up. It's going to pop the bed out of place. There's going to be a platform that comes down. And then here comes your bed down here. And then you are going to get two lights over here. So you're going to get blue lights. And then you're going to get regular headlights out here for your lights at night. And then if you can see from the video, they do have still have the cubby holes here. So your cubby holes are good for CPAP machines, your phones at night, whatever you need to charge, you can get done because there's two 110 outlets over here on each side. And then there's a USB outlet and there should be a USB-C outlet now on these units. So they're going to both USB styles, which is really nice. You still get storage overhead here and you still get cabinet space on either side. Battery cables in here with your tongue jack, with your jack and stabilizer down, and then your outdoor shower sprays in this one too. Pull out drawers here, and then this should be duplicated on the other side then too, so you still get storage on the other side of this bed as well. But this is with the bed down. As you can see, the table is right here, so I don't really have that much room to walk by, honestly, but if I really needed to, I could get by. But this is honestly a couple's unit, so you're not looking to have anybody else staying with you if it's only for the two of you. So when the bed's down, perfect space where you're still able to get up and you're able to come over here and head back to the bathroom. Let's take a look. So here's the Murphy bed with those two storage spaces on either side like I talked to you guys about. Over here is going to be your instant hot water heater. So you can take care of that here, hot, cold, whatever you need is going to be right here for you. And then all your systems, your one control is all going to be here. So your tanks, your ceiling light, exterior light, your water pumps here, and your awning is still electric, so it's right here. And then you can get the Lippert One Control app, which I can put out a video for that. It's very simple, but there should be other videos out there. I might pin the Lippert one so you guys can look over it. And then you can hit connect here, and then you can run your system solely on your phone, which is pretty cool. And then this is going to be your space for making food, so table space. So this is going to be your sink. So this is going to pop up for you, and then your shower head's going to pop up for you. Not shower head, sorry, water head, as I get winterized on my finger. So that's your little sink. Nothing too impressive, but you know, it is an under 20-foot unit, so is the space they're going to be able to provide you during it. Let's put that back down with that. And then you are getting the two-burner propane stove tops, which are really nice. So you still get two, and this is still going to flip up like any other imagined stove top would. So it's your own little backsplash as well. And then I have the light on with it there. And then obviously you still get your fan on here too. Fan doesn't work. I'm not hooked up to 110. And then you do get microwave below. And then these are going to be your storage points for this unit. So two pull-out drawers here. You do get a pull-out drawer there for pots and pans if you want to. You're still gonna get some storage underneath the sink too, so still deep storage underneath the sink as well. And then you get four points up here, so all the storage up here. So you get these two storage doors up here, and then you still get two above, like the little lightning fan system of the graystone. You still get two big deep storage points here, and also to the left of that then too, guess what? You still get a big storage point. So they still try to pack in as much storage as they can on this little 20-foot unit. And then they are giving you the Nord cold refrigerator. So that is your Nord cold refrigerator there. And then you do get a little freezer point down below then too. So nothing major, but enough for you to use if you're going for a weekend camping trip and you're looking for something under 5,000. They're making sure to look out for you and give you enough space so you can go that whole weekend without going back and getting food. TV is obviously right here in this spot too. So when you're laying down in the Murphy bed, you can see across the point and still be able to see the TV. You still get your table here and dinette. So this table will still go down into a bed and this will still fold down. So say if grandkids or something come with, you can still fold this down into a bedroom, which is still pretty nice. So you still get a little extra sleeping room in a short unit, but you really don't need it. But you still get a table to sit out and eat as well on the inside. And then obviously, nice big window here. And then you are going to get a window on the other side of your bedroom. Let's go check out the bathroom. Alrighty, as you guys can tell, the bar to close the shower head is right here at my door and my face, so I am above it. But my headroom on this little moonroof is high enough. If you can see, my head is not hitting that. So I don't hit it tall-wise. Width-wise, I'm as wide as the shower almost, but I still will get a little bit of room in here. I can still pull the slider shade over me and still be able to get a nice little quick shower. So half and half big man approved, but still, for a 20-foot camper, what are you really gonna ask for out of a shower? But it'll still get the job done. So yeah, semi big man approved. And then rounding out this bathroom, you do get a nice window out the back too. As you can see, welcome to snowy Pennsylvania this morning. Your toilet's located right by the shower. And then also, there's your cabinets, hello. You do get storage up top, storage to the right side, and then they always still give you the toilet paper holder. If you want to screw that in somewhere, they give the ability to still get a toilet holder. You get a towel rack here, and then you get two pull-out drawers here. Nothing too big, because again, that outside griddle is right there, so they're not going to be deep storage points, because you are, again, that outside griddle. But you still get room here for space on the counter, which is nice. And they do give you two hangers there, too, for towels or whatever you need it for. But again, for a unit that's about under 20 feet, this is a bigger bathroom and still a good amount of space to take a shower, get changed, whatever you may need. Still big enough. Hey guys, thank you again for watching this walk around video, the Grand Design Imagine 15RB. Make sure you hit that like and sub button. You guys have been great watching our videos, getting it out there. I know this isn't a long video because it is only about a 19 feet, 11 inch unit. So under 20 foot unit, isn't going to take a long time to walk around. Doesn't have a slide or anything like that. It's just a short and sweet, simple unit. If you're looking to go boondocking and you don't want to travel with such a big unit, but you still want the quality of Grand Design look, this is definitely the unit for you. And you just want a couples coach, 100%, make sure you come and check out this 15RB by Grand Design. Hope you guys have a wonderful weekend. Hope you guys have a Merry Christmas. And we will see you next week in another walk around video. Have a good weekend, guys. Merry Christmas.